Well, folks, welcome to this week's A Sportsman's Life. Look who Mr. Jeff and I have with us. Mr. Whitetail is going to be has been part of our show for a few weeks. Larry is going to impart some knowledge each week and some fun.
It's all fun.
It is all fun, and I am truly honored to be with you guys. I'll tell you what, Luke and I have been doing radio for a while, almost 11 years, every Saturday morning or throughout the week as well, too, and I've had the opportunity to spend time around Jeff through Luke, and I am truly honored to be part of this. And really what I'm kind of, my kind of part that I kind of see is kind of a Q&A kind of thing, where we'll talk about different hunting tips, learning about optics, learning about hunting gear, learning about rifles, all those kind of things.
Yeah.
Just pure, simple information that you may already know, but, you know, there are a lot of people getting into the outdoors. So we're going to try to take it very basically and bring it forward.
Excellent. And, folks, if you think running with these two rascals is not fun, this is really serious hard work. But we're going to jump into our show. So stay with us every week. Larry's going to be here. Jeff's always with us. We're going to have a great time, and we want you to be right here every week with us.
We have been here, what, maybe 10 minutes?
No, you threw it out, and immediately this one started working on it.
We need about, let's see, you can eat three, I can eat 10 more. Then we'll have lunch.
We'll get another.
I got a stringer laying around somewhere.
Turn a hog hunt into, it's all fun, but...
Oh, you bet.
Who knows what a hog's going to do? They decided not to move, but we know there's
hogs are hogs, but this place is just so fantastic. I mean, with the habitat that's here, and then you got this here behind you, and then you got Lake Park just right behind you as well.
Yep. Well, fun stuff.
Amazing. I say we try to get some more catfish.
Let's have some more fun.
Let's do it.
All right. Well, friends, we've caught, what have we caught? About five or six maybe already?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. We got lunch.
Yes, we do.
Fish fry happening.
That one that you should have caught, Jeff, that makes up for another two of them, I'll tell you.
Yeah, that was a good one. There's some nice ones out there. They're just coming up to the surface, and they're feeding on some of the fish food that we've got here in the Sweeney. Boy, I tell you what, they like that stuff, don't they?
Yeah, you know, the neat thing, these are wild fish. We're not fishing in a pond, you know.
Right.
I mean, this creek that goes on and on, but this fish food every day. I think that's one reason there's such a concentration, because we have seen 8 or 10 up on top, just like in a stock pond, you know, when they feed in a stock pond on a fish feeder.
Yeah.
So that works on lake fish too, doesn't it? You know?
Sure.
Well, I'm sure too with that you're pulling up a lot of little bait fish as well too, because they're coming in to probably eat what's left.
So Luke, tell our viewing audience what we're using for bait here.
Yeah, you know, this is not a commercial, my friends, but this bait is called Stick It, Magic Bait Company. And it's kind of interesting, about 10 years ago, Mr. Hampton, that owns Magic Bait Company, contacted me and wanted me to get a group of four fishing guides, catfish guides together. And they started with Formula A, and I think the final product was Formula G or something, this right here. But yeah, it's on the market. It's called Stick It. And it's, you might take a look at it. It's not a foul bait, you know, not too strong smelling, but it does bring them in. Man, we've caught them.
Oh, it works fantastic. We've been catching them on it. And the nice thing about it is you can put it on your hook and your fingers don't stink like,
exactly. I mean, it's good bait. I use a couple of tubs of it every summer. But here, this kind of fishing will ruin you, Larry.
Oh, man.
You know?
This is fantastic.
So easy.
It is easy, but I mean, you look at the surroundings that you have here too, with a little marshy area right back over here in catfish, and there's no telling what else is in this creek right here, because it is connected all the way to Lake Park. So, like I said, with the fish food that you've had out, I'm sure that's attracted bait fish, which has attracted, you know, new Lake Record Park largemouth bass could be right there too.
Could be, you bet. We've certainly caught our share of fish in this creek. It's a lot of fun. It's a lot of fun.
And you know, in the springtime, we tested the white bass fishing year before last and just hammered them down here, didn't we?
We sure did.
It's just neat to have a place with hogs right, well, like we've seen hogs on the bank right there.
Guess
very often.
Yeah.
And pretty cool to to have such a place, Jeff. It's, you've done a lot of work here, buddy.
This is a little spot you can hunt and fish at the same time. I kind of like that.
Yeah,
although my wife and I come down here and sit, we'll fish, and I never bring a weapon down here. We're sitting down here fishing, and we always see hogs across the creek, and it's like, geez, we could be hunting too. But
well, not only that, we've been sitting here, and I mean, the bird life here is phenomenal. There's something going on all the time, to where you're seeing all kind of little birds that you might not see anyplace else.
A creek is just an interesting place to be able to get back in here like this, and you know. And get to a spot like this.
You know, Jeff, for all of our friends listening, the truth is, across the creek, they can't see all this now, but across the creek is, well, it's the upper end of the lake, but it's probably, there might be a little water back there now, but on and on the bottoms, nobody's there except critters. And this, the cool thing, this is right on the edge of all that.
Mm-hmm.
Hogs bed up back there, they probably hogs never seen any but a human, really.
Likely so.
Yeah.
Likely so.
Well, I think I need to catch another fish.
Whoa, did you hear that one?
I'm watching those over there. I'll tell you what, they're just coming up and tailing and splashing
man.
Carrying on.
They are in here.
This is a way to turn a hog hunt into a fun fishing
outfit. Oh, no question.
You know?
Absolutely beautiful.
Be versatile, you know, you got to be adaptable.
That's right.
Exactly, Larry. You bet.
It's all about good times in the outdoors.
That's,
you know,
right.
You can be hunting,
yes,
you can be fishing, you can be sitting around a campfire, right, boys?
That's exactly right. And you know, I've learned through the years on any kind of an outdoor activity that you do, you know, if you just only have fun when you shoot the big buck or the big hog, if that's the only time you enjoy it, it's sad.
You're missing out.
You're missing out.
Missing out.
Of course, I guess like every other, when I was a young man, it was all about getting one. But now I've learned to enjoy the rest of the story.
It's really, you know, it's just about being out there. It, you know, the harvest is a part of it, but it's not.
It's not all of it.
It's not all of it. It's certainly not. Some of the stories we've shared, you know, last night and this morning.
Yep.
Sitting around having a good cooked breakfast, pot of coffee, and stroll down here and do this. I mean, that's fun stuff.
Exactly. You bet.
And you know, if we didn't even catch a fish, we still had a good time.
Oh, absolutely.
But we have caught fish.
We have caught
a bucket.
We got a bucket
right
full.
Yep.
Yeah, we do.
Yep.
We're seeing all, like I said, I love looking at all the little birds. There's so many different little birds that I'm seeing here that I don't see where I normally am. And to me, that's part of the fun as well, too.
Yeah. One messing with you is down there, Luke?
No.
Or is that you?
I'm on the bottom now, so what we'd be waiting for is that torch start taking off, you know?
All right. A breeze. Did you feel that?
I have.
Wow.
Yeah.
That's what we need, a breeze.
You can live with that.
Yeah.
It's been pretty still. It stayed that way yesterday until that little storm blew up. And finally got a cool breeze coming through there, but there was a while.
It lasted, what, about a minute?
Yeah. But that minute, was
that was a good minute. Yeah, it was.
Okay, so let's make a plan. Let's think ahead here a little bit.
Okay.
Larry is all about catching big perch, big brim.
Yeah.
And there's a log jam down there. We know where it's at. It's some deep water.
You
I
bet.
Just know that thing has got to have some big... Get him, Larry. Bring him in, buddy. Another eater.
I'm daydreaming when you sit there.
Yeah, well, I was thinking about perch.
I'm thinking.
Here we need to be talking.
Dreaming perch, catching catfish. All right.
That'll make two nice fillets.
Oh, man, yeah.
You betcha.
You bet.
Look at that. Fun stuff.
That is fun stuff.
Here's some pliers here. We'll get him undone here in a minute.
Yeah, we're going to need a plier on this one.
All right. Yeah. Let me have him. Wait.
I got him good and tight.
I'll tell you what we'll do.
You clip that top one.
I got gun shy on that earlier, right?
What's the string?
Let me have him.
You got him?
Got it, yep.
Mm-hmm. All right.
Got a little tension there on that.
Oh. But we lost the broke line. No worries.
That's all right.
We'll retie. We'll see if Lou can get that out of there without tearing a barb up or tearing a hook up there.
Okay, here we go. There you go. Okay, a couple of them.
Add one to the pile there, my friend.
Dos filetes, is that those, right?
Yeah, well,
that sounds good to me.
That sounds good to me, too.
Fun stuff.
Yeah, we got it.
All right.
We about got a bucket. Y'all, what are we doing? We want to keep fishing, or what, y'all? What time is it? 9? Run around, whatever.
Let's go run around a little bit.
You want to go run around? We got a bucket full, so.
We got a bucket full.
We got more than, well, solid.
Did it? Don't tell me it moved. No.
Larry?
I had just looked at it, and then I looked over to the right, and I couldn't see it, and I thought, oh, my God.
Buddy, they might call you Mr. Whitetail, but after today, it may be Mr. Channel Cat.
I know I like to eat them, I'll tell you.
I know, that's true. Okay.
All right.
Well, what do we want? We'll roll everything.
Yeah, let's do that.
Let's roll it in, and let's climb on the buggy and
go look for a haul.
We'll go buzz around. You bet. All right, folks.
That's what it's all about.
We'll be back.
Well, hello, my friends. It's your old buddy Luke Clayton, and I'm coming to you from out in the woods by my little cabin behind the house here in the trees. I want to talk to you today, maybe get you fired up doing something you're hunting a little different. For years and years, I grew up shooting when I was a kid, 30-30, and I still hunt with a 30-30 sometime. Then I became a bow hunter. That's all I did. What do you hunt with? Oh, I'm a bow hunter. Well, I'm still a bow hunter, but I hunt with other things too. And I found it to be a lot of fun. This is an Air Force Air Guns Texan, folks, 45 caliber. I shoot Nelson Specialty Ammo Swage bullets in this thing. Big old bullets, 240 grains and bigger. I've probably killed 30 hogs, just guessing, with it. I've killed a lot of exotics, 8 or 10 exotics. I killed a nice buck up on the Dale River Ranch with my Air Force Air Guns Texan. It's a hammer for hogs. Why did I get started in you shooting a big bore air gun, or air guns in general? I can answer that. I knew nothing about a PCP air gun that you air up with a tank. And it was just a fun learning curve. And I still love to hunt with my Texan. And I do, a lot. Another air gun. This is a Seneca Dragon Claw. And it shoots bullets also. But it shoots the air bolt. You see Mr. Wysoon, Larry, with us quite a bit. He shot a good eater pig, you might remember, recently with his Seneca Dragon Claw. So, you know, load it with an arrow. Not legal during archery season, so don't worry about that. But during rifle season, it's just something different that you might want to try. Seneca Dragon Claw, 50 caliber. Now, if I want to go out, say I want to hunt hogs at night, I have the Wraith right here by Sightmark. You've seen me bragging on this and actually seen a lot of video of the Wraith. It's a, you know, digital night vision. It's a day and night scope, actually. I've hunt with it during the day. Use it at night also. I mean, it's just shoot a hog at 125 yards on a pitch dark night, no problem. So I have it mounted on probably a little contradictory to what most hog hunters do. They have the ARs, but mounted on a little 223. And this, I have killed a bunch of hogs. So if I want to shoot a hog at night, I grab this, make sure my batteries are hot in my Wraith, and I go get them. Now, okay, what about the old 30-30? I still like to hunt with it. It's what, you stalking hogs in the woods, this little thing is so light. I did mount a quality peep sight on the back. I had to buy another front sight that was the right height. This thing at 75 yards will shoot a 2-inch group all day long and out to 100. I feel comfortable shooting it out to 100 yards. So another tool that I hunt with. Am I a 30-30 hunter? Sometimes, but not all the time. And then something that's really overlooked, in my opinion, is small game hunting. This is a Ruger 10/22 scoped, and it's an absolute tack driver. I sighted in at about 50 feet where it's dead on for squirrel hunting. You can knock the squirrel out of the tallest pin oak tree with this. So what I'd like you to take away from this little segment here, don't be afraid to try something new. Don't box yourself in that, you know, to the point that you won't try a new sporting arm or a bow or whatever. Try something new, and don't forsake, you know, dance with what brung you. I still shoot my, you know, my gearhead bows, and but it's just so much fun, really, folks, to try different things in the outdoors. So we'll get back to our show. Hopefully this will maybe spark you on. If you've never done, I have a muzzle loader in there in the cabin. I still hunt with a muzzle loader every now and then. I still like it. But try something new in the outdoors, folks. I think it might just put the spark back into your hunting. Well, folks, it is your old buddy Luke Clayton. And did that barbecue look tasty or what? I tell you, this is some of the best, to me, one of the best ways to cook meat that there is barbecue. I want to share with you how I cooked it and the type of meats that I like to cook. Now, this was a beef roast right here. It could just as easily have been wild venison, you know, game meat, exotic meat, wild pork. The whole key is cooking it slow and with moisture. Now, the way I cook this roast, and it is beef, but I put an aluminum pan and I put it in the pan and I smoked it about 3 hours with hickory wood. And folks, here is some of this very, very tasty barbecue that's cooked in my smoking tex. So real easy to make. You can make this out of venison, pork, you know, beef. I guess we'd call it pulled pork if we actually use pork, but beef, venison, any kind of game meat, elk. Very, very tasty. I'll go into great detail on how I prepped it and how we turned it into some really tender barbecue. Folks, before I gave this the 12 hours or 13 hours smoking, I gave it a generous rub of Rodax coffee rub. And of course, I put some of the best of Texas barbecue sauce on it. But that's as simple a recipe as I could come up with. Just basically slow cooking, moisture, wrap it in foil. You can turn a venison roast into every bit as tasty as this one right here. You know, as old Gus on Lonesome Dove said, I don't know what you can do with the information, folks, but here it is. So hopefully in your freezer, you can, you know, if you're going to have some game meat, I'll bet you might even have some venison steaks. You can use those and cook them just like I did this and have some awesome barbecue. But while you are at home, try some of this outdoor cooking. I guarantee you'll enjoy it and your whole family will eat well. Folks, as an old outdoors writer, I have used lots of products. Smokin' Tex electric smokers, the best smokers that you can find. This is Diz and this is Scott, my buddies. Diz, tell them how they can learn more about Smokin' Tex.
Yeah, obviously the number one source of information is going to be our website. It's got hundreds of recipes, it's got helpful guides, it's got all of our models and our accessories listed there. Of course, we have a phone number, 888-922-1511, and we'll actually answer our own phones.
That's true. And there's the main thing, the easy way, smokingtex.com. You can learn all about it.
Correct. And of course, we're on all the social media, Instagram, Facebook, etc. So take a look at us whenever you can, and whatever social media you'd like. And we look forward to working with you.
Well, folks, you know, a couple of years ago, Texas made it legal to hunt with air rifles, big bore air rifles. Now, me and my buddy, Mr. Wysoon here, Larry has got an air rifle that shoots arrows.
Also known as bolts, I have learned.
Bolts. Bolts or arrows. And this is the Seneca Dragon Claw, 50 caliber. It also shoots bullets.
It does. I prefer to shoot the arrows because It's a little bit different compared to everything that I've done in the past. I used to tease people, you ever going to shoot a bow again? I said, yeah, as soon as I can shoot it out of a gun. Well, guess what? Now I can shoot a broadhead bolt out of an air gun.
That's right.
Particular model.
And we're out here hog hunting on our buddy Jeff Rice's Bucking Bass Ranch. Got a broadhead on there. Cape buffalo have been killed with this rig.
Right. Keith Warren is taking Cape Buffalo, and I don't tell him what else he's taking in Africa. So it's a great tool. It's a new way of hunting as far as I'm concerned, and I'm anxious to try it this year.
And Larry, that's part of it. It was new to me when I first started shooting air guns about 9 years, big bore air guns, PCP guns. It was brand new, and that was part of the allure to me. It was something new, and I got to learn about it. Now, so Larry has the arrow hunting with the bolt or the arrow covered with the Seneca Dragon Claw. Great setup. Now, if you want to use, this is what I hunt with. This is Air Force Air Guns Texan. Now, this is the carbine model. They make a longer barreled model that gets a little more velocity, but I've killed a bunch of critters, hogs, and killed a nice buck with this rig last year. So Air Force Air Guns Texan, they make, this is 45 caliber. They make a 50 caliber, which I haven't shot yet, but this will generate over 500 foot-pounds of energy. So bullets, Mr. Wysoon's got his arrows. You think, well, what kind of bullets? You'd think, well, it's an air gun, maybe a little light bullet. These are swage bullets here. And Nielsen Specialty Ammo makes them. Now, you probably can't see them this close, but they're a very well-made, well-designed bullet as far as for air guns, strictly. So, Larry, I think we've maybe give the folks a good primer in air gunology.
It is. It's a new way of hunting. Legal now in Texas. Bows, this one can't be used during the archery season, but it can be used with an arrow during the regular hunting season. So, just something new to play with and a new kind of adventure. And if you haven't tried it yet, let me suggest that you do. I think you'll be truly impressed.
I think so, Larry. And for folks that, well, where do I get all this stuff? Pyramid Air is the largest air gun supply company in the world. Just go to Pyramid Air. They have people there that you can actually call if you have, you're gonna have some questions. If you don't know someone that's already shooting these big bores, well, Pyramid Air has some folks that can help you out. So hopefully this little tutorial with Mr. Wysoon and myself, hopefully it'll help you get started in something that's fun to do.
Well, friends, the end result. What do you think?
I think, you know, hog hunting's special when it comes right down to it, but I'll tell you what, being able to go out and catch fish and then watch one of your really good friends clean them for you. Now that's really special.
That's even better, yeah.
You're getting a good, nice pile of fillets and then you and your wife be dining on these tomorrow probably, right?
Absolutely, yeah. Absolutely. Tomorrow afternoon.
All right, well, we'll get these filleted up, get your boys on the road. We want to thank you for visiting, Larry, as always.
I can't wait to come back. Thank y'all so very much for allowing me to be here. Luke and I will have a few more things to talk about on the radio, too.
It's been a blast, like always. I appreciate getting to spend time with both of y'all.
Well, it's mutual here. You guys are special, and you make me feel even more special, I'll tell you.
Well, it's kind of what friends are for.
That's right.
Amen.
That is, absolutely. I've told people, you know, that one of the, not to get all philosophical here, but the big prize of my life is friends.
It is.
That's what, absolutely. You know, and I've been fortunate. I have some good ones, and you guys are two of them. Y'all know that.
Let me get back to work here.
Enough philosophizing.
Well, friends, welcome back. Thanks again for joining us on this week's show. Gosh, guys, we have so much fun doing this stuff, don't you think? I mean,
I know. This is out of this world fun. Oh. I can't tell you how much I appreciate and how honored I truly am to be with you guys. Well, and all those folks out there, too.
Absolutely. We want to thank you folks for joining us each week. We have fun bringing this stuff to you, and we certainly appreciate you joining us, liking us, sharing us, and joining us for another adventure. We'll have another exciting adventure next week, so stay tuned. And until then, be safe in the outdoors.
And a special thanks to Air Force Air Guns, Dallas Safari Club, Hornaday, Pyramid Air, Nielsen Specialty Ammo, Sightmark, Smoke and Tex, and Striper Express.